please regard, first I would like to open the floor for any question and answers. We have a pretty good discussion since morning, covering many aspects like metrics, you know, and efficiency cycles, then benchmarking, then we have presentation from the solution provider, Ethan, one is on UPF, and the CHP. So first I would like to open the floor for any question where the panel members can answer. Can we have one microphone, please? Yeah. Any questions from the floor? Please identify yourself and then you can ask questions to any speaker.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Yap from Dax Goa. Questions for the panel here is today we have a presentation talking about raising the supply and temperature. Everybody recognize that the cooling energy is somewhat one of the key energy area that we should look at towards the models. But when we are going to raise the supply air temperature to about 26.7 Celsius, how can you address on the humidity issues? Anyone?
I think before you even try to address raising the temperature of the data center to 26.7, you do need to look at, particularly older data centers, whether your servers are actually capable of sustaining operations at those temperatures. What we've found is that, yes, the newer servers are ideally suited to those higher temperatures, but it's always a balance. Temperature and humidity. I think ASHRAE are now saying in terms of humidity that it's plus 45 to 55 degrees RH, which is pushing the boundary a little bit from where it was, say, 10 years ago when we were very tight constraints over humidity. Humidity is an issue in this part of the world. Particularly, as I said this morning, in places like Dubai, where the temperature is 50 degrees centigrade, very dry, it's quite easy to maintain the temperature balance. But when you introduce humidity into the equation, then it is a very delicate balancing act. But if you've got too little RH, you can add water to the system, so your input air could be can have a hot water boiler visit. If you want to take it out, it is just a case of removing that atmospheric air before it gets into the chiller cycle. That might be one of the methods that could be used in Malaysia, for example, or you know, as somebody said this morning, there are recycle systems. Condensing system, condensing boilers, things like that can be used in that respect. So there's a lot of technologies available. And I don't think the issue of temperature and humidity is a major issue so long as it's balanced correctly. So if you're going to lower or raise the temperature, you need to address the humidity problem at the same time. But most intelligent air handling systems will manage that for you anyway. So long as you
anyone want to comment on?
Does that answer the question you had or just confuse the situation?
Generally, I would expect somewhat the same answer, I guess, but because the topic here is tropical data center energy efficiency, so I would recommend 26.7 Celsius. That's about air for this environment here. That's raised my concern on the humidity issue because in Malaysia, RH level is pretty high. Most of the good data centers usually will be standing positively pressurized, which means you will bring in some fresh air into the data center. So I'd like to know when we recommend something like what do we do, what is behind our mind, not just addressing, follow the trend, jumping on the bandwagon, raising temperature as to aspirational, what do we do to ensure that we still stay at the operating, the recommended operating community range, more so for some of the polo labor here, to still able to comply with this. But anyways, that answer was...
I think that's a very valid point. I don't think we should follow Ashwaya just because it's Ashwaya or Simpson or Israel or whoever. I think you have to look at the right circumstances. But conditioning the air, the input air, so if you've got the fresh air supply or recirculating air, you can condition that air supply in terms of humidity before it enters the chiller cycle. So the balancing of RH is a fairly simple thing to do. In Europe, you would add a hot water system to your input air, whereas here you want to be removing the humidity. So that means it's just a case of conditioning the air before it goes into the chiller cycle or into the room cycle. And not, as you say, not following Ashwaya simply to follow Ashwaya. It has to offer you a benefit at the end of the day. As I said this morning, you need to take small steps. And I asked people to raise their hand at 26, 27, there were no takers. So, you know, don't go to 26, 27, take it in incremental steps. Make sure you have the technology in the data center to manage what it is you want to achieve. That's the secret one. Because you've got to give a return on investment to your the finance people at the end of the day. If it doesn't meet your needs, don't do it. It's as simple as that.
On top of that, what I would say is this is a very good point for researchers to investigate how an old data center or how a new data center behaves when you actually change this temperature set, you know, that we need to, that the ASHRAE guidelines are applicable, or benefits or not. It's a good point to investigate by taking a modular data center from a higher data center. Then, the results are very good to share among this community. Any question?